What's up, big money gang? Hey, we're gonna finally review Avatar 2, The Way of the Wata. So we did Earth, right? Like, Earth, because the forest people, and the second one's water. The third one gonna be air, or is it technically the forest people are Earth and air? Is this gonna be like a different element every, never mind. So, Avatar 2, Jake Sully and his girl, you know, they got a family now. He's full on forest people, it's been some years. But Earth is like, nah. We still want the smoke. And we want this planet, even though it's inhabitable to us because of the gas. But, you know, we still want what we can't have. Jake Sully's like, yo. They want the smoke, okay. But now he got a family. So he's like, I don't know if I really want the smoke. Because I gotta watch out for my family. Because I'm a dad now. You know, the kids be like, dad. And be like, no, my kids. They be like, dad. They be like, my kids. Something like that. He does not sell propane accessories. But I think that would be a good lifestyle for him. So it's been 13 years since the first movie, and I rewatched the first movie before I actually watched the second one. I mean, like, literally back to back. Like, I watched it within, like, 30 minutes. I completed watching it within 30 minutes of watching the second one. And it's not doo-doo, I can tell you that much. The first one, it's charming. There's, like, some elements and, like, feel good moments and the basis of a story. It is a story. It is a movie. But with Avatar 2, it's more of the same, I would say. I think that things I didn't like about this is that it's very predictable. I said that in a YouTube short. Right, but the story has certain beats and certain things that you have definitely seen before. It is redone. I don't want to talk about concepts, right? But like the idea of now is not Jake Sully that has to adapt, right? It's him and his entire family now has to adapt to a new way of life. So it's the same premise to a degree as the first one, right? Because Jake Sully had to adapt to the Na'vi way of life, and now they have to adapt to the way of the Wata. So that was fine, right? It's like, okay. And like how they're going to move the characters away into this new land makes sense, right? And then how Earth came about and the same villains, it kind of makes sense, but it just feels like you could have done something new. But I think one of the problems is that the script was made a long time ago and it didn't really get any updates. That's what I think, so it kind of feels. This movie feels a bit outdated. The story feels a bit outdated for 2022. So to clarify what I'm saying, if you've seen the recent Scream movie, and there's a scene in the opening where, this isn't really spoilers, but the scene in the opening where one of the main cast is talking to the killer, and the type of conversation about, like, difference between like 90s and 80s horror as opposed to now, and they bring up like the Babadook, I think you can still enjoy both 80s and 90s horror. You can still enjoy those, but what I think the conversation is about is like about nuance and oversimplification. And 80s and those 90s, those early horror movies, it really can be oversimplified. I think the story, in a sense, is oversimplified. It doesn't have too much nuance besides, like, the message of, like, trying to save the earth and appreciate nature and appreciate the world that we have because it's beautiful and you should do that. That's where I'm coming from with that. And that this movie, story-wise, probably would have done better in like 2012, 2013. That being said, the visuals would not look the same. And I think that's important to state. The story may be outdated, but the visuals are very up to date. I don't think it's much as a phenomenon as it was, but you can tell they did that thing here with that. Kind of like if you're watching, like if you're watching Bleach right now, if the story continued back, what, it was like 2010, 2012, right? The animation would not look as nice as it does now. So I do need to say that. That the animation and the technology has vastly improved. And I think that's one of the things that really shine here. But are things that I did like. But before I go to things that I did like. This movie can feel a bit long. There's definitely times where I wanted to like go to sleep. And I definitely saw a father in the movie theater pass out. Which was just kind of funny because his family like turn around and just like, oh, he's asleep. Even about to wake him. He's paying for everything. Things that I did like. It's a beautiful film. Like, I can't say that it's not a beautiful film at all. It's very pleasing to the eyes. It has a sense of wonder that James Cameron really wanted to show, and he does provide in this movie. Even like the characters themselves are just like, ah, and like, ooh, and I got that, you know. And you get that sense of that as well. You do get immersed in the film, in the world of it. But only for so long. I think that there are a few things that happen between characters. Not like the father, but the family. There's some issues I had with the family that are just like, I know why this is happening, but it doesn't make it any more pleasurable for me while watching this. So, I had to make sure that while watching this, I tried to like take a step back. I'm not saying this is like a mind-numbing movie, like you have to like completely disregard everything for it, but you may have to sometimes. I think that if you enjoy the first one, you're gonna really enjoy this movie. If you have not, if you did not enjoy the first one, this probably isn't for you. I think that's the big indicator of how you felt about the first movie, and it's gonna be how you feel about the second movie. So if you didn't like the first movie, I would say don't watch it, right? If you did like the first movie, you're probably gonna enjoy this. So that's really what it is. Am I gonna probably go see Avatar 3? Probably. It's very rarely that, like, once I start something, I don't finish it unless it's that bad. This is how I end up watching the Twilight movies, because I thought the first Twilight was gonna be an action movie with vampires. And I was very, very wrong. Very, very wrong. So yeah. Off the cut, I'll probably say mid, right? But if I have to rate it as suit, which I will because it's like my whole little niche, I guess. Is that the right word? Niche? Whatever. I would say it is a chicken salad with no dressing. Yeah. Ever trying to eat salad with no dressing, it's not the best. Yeah, you don't get no dressing. It's chicken salad. Chicken, you know, use the quotations, grilled chicken. I don't know why I put quotations about the grilled chicken, but you know, that piece of chicken breast is dry. You got the tomatoes, though. It's like a well-put salad, but it's dry. It's a dry chicken sandwich. Chicken salad with no dressing. You have no dressing in the house. They ran out of dressing in the restaurant. And then you're like, I thought this was going to be good. But now, good Lord, please help me. You got water, though. You got a cup of water. So it's a chicken salad with no dressing, but you got a cup of water. I kind of want salad now. But yeah, like always, turn on all 37 notifications and subscribe to the channel. And like always, you are a human being and you are loved. And like always, until we meet again.